if coin joins become cheaper, wouldn't that be a massive incentive for like wallet developers to just implement privacy by default?
Yes, but then are they implementing privacy or are they implementing coin joins for cost savings? I think the best case scenario is that, well, there's no difference, right? Yes, by implementing this cost saving measure, they would be implementing privacy by default. And in a sense, layer two protocols also kind of do that, right? They hide the details of individual transactions, but the raison d'etre of Lightning right now is to allow you to amortize, to make a whole bunch of individual economic transactions with much better finality guarantees, and aggregate all of those together so that, like, in principle, you can pay a fixed cost for an arbitrary amount of activity. I think it's a matter of definitions. Like, are they building privacy by default, or are they just economizing the? And yes, the best outcome is for both of those to be the same thing.
My last question is, can you expand a little bit on your idea about virtual UTXOs? That sounds extremely interesting to me.
So I think the term was, or at least the way I was introduced to it, is Jeremy Rubin's work. So you can go to utxos.org. He has a whole bunch of cool ideas there. And I think specifically the term virtual UTXOs is referring to congestion control trees. So this is the idea that, like, if you have like 1,000 users at an exchange and they all withdraw, well, the dumb way to do that is like Coinbase was doing in the 2017 like high fee events, which is you just write a shitty Ruby wallet and ignore coin selection entirely and externalize the cost to your users. The next logical step after that is batching. But if you have covenants, well, now the exchange can just create a single output which guarantees every user the ability to eventually have an on-chain coin in the UTXO set. And the reason that that's guaranteed is because the rules of that output constrain it so that it must be so. However, there's a cost associated with it. I think the trick is you don't, like, the lower your time preference for obtaining that final output, the higher the likelihood that other users will pay the fees for you. And that's kind of the idea behind congestion control trees. It's a whole like tree of transactions where let's say there's like 3 users in a virtual UTXO. Any one of those could be the first to broadcast a transaction that spends it. And the resulting outputs of that transaction are going to be still like 3 coins spendable by the 3 users. But like Alice, Bob, and Carol, like each of them has a distinct transaction where the cost to them is higher. So if they want to broadcast that earlier, then they're entitled to, or they can wait for some of the other users to do that. With Taproot, this becomes, I think, much more promising because that gives us the opportunity to coordinate and say, well, okay, maybe Alice already broadcast something, and that's why it's a tree structure. So now Bob and Carol can say, well, we still have this output, which underneath it are hidden, like both of our outputs. Let's open a Lightning channel between us or something. And then they can just spend that output wholesale and avoid the cost. Ultimately, the general concept is both still have some number of Satoshis over which they have unilateral control. And that to me is a virtual UTXO. It's control over an allocation of Satoshis with a lot of different ways of actually realizing it. There's a related mailing list post by I think Antoine Riard or Gleb Domenko from about a year ago they worked on it together, and I don't remember who posted, but CoinPool is this idea where, like, you could have something that's conceptually very much like a coin join, except it's just one multisig output for all the users. And then if, like, so instead of having a single transaction with many outputs, many inputs and many outputs, now you have a single transaction with many inputs and one output, and then that seems kind of dumb. Like, why would you extra fee is kind of the aggregated all our inputs. We've created a single multisig output. We could resolve that and end the protocol where every one of us has an output themselves, or we could just keep going, add more users, build more multisig outputs. So spending the multisig into coin joins and having that represent the actions of multiple users together, that would be a way of obtaining much more privacy for a smaller block space footprint overall. The concept of a virtual UTXO is just a very abstract building block of control over some sats, which are not yet self-evident in the UTXO set right now. Like, it's not just I broadcast a transaction to spend that confirmed coin. It's like, now I need to think about a whole sequence of transactions and how they interconnect. And that's a lot of complexity, but it's complexity that we can afford to do because it's off-chain coordination and it relies on cooperation. It's not a global consensus system that inherently has scaling issues.
I'm wary of time, but I've got one question I wanted to ask. I think this is probably better for Adam actually to answer, I'm guessing, although I'm not entirely certain, but you mentioned it as well, Yuval, and I think Adam, you mentioned it too, is the Lightning Network, right? Like, both of you mentioned it, and Adam, obviously I saw you out in El Salvador, and you've been there, and you see that there's a lot of use of the Lightning Network going on there. I mean, comparatively to in other areas of the world. And I saw that you guys last month, I think, I can't remember now, but you had like a Bitcoin grant. At least I think it was Wasabi. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I had a Bitcoin grant for basically anyone designing a privacy focused Lightning wallet. I wanted to know, you know, as much as you'd be willing to share publicly, like what are your guys, because obviously you guys are kind of working hard on and focusing rightfully on Bitcoin, the base layer, and kind of implementing privacy there. But obviously as time goes on, I imagine there's gonna be more and more popularity and use of Lightning and other layer twos and potentially further layers. So what are your guys' plans, I guess specifically with the Lightning Network? Like, have you got any kind of ideas of where you want to go over the next couple of years, or what are you thinking there?
No, thanks a lot for asking this question, because it's actually the grant was announced at the conference, so 2 weeks ago, but it's a one Bitcoin. Okay, so why are we, what are we doing, and why? In what we want to build in Bitcoin is a money that is anonymous, fast, cheap, secure, uninflatable. So basically an ideal money, something that fulfills the properties of good money, right? And of course the problem with Bitcoin or the problem with all the blockchains is that blockchains don't scale, right? So somehow we have to create payments. Those are cheap and fast. And that's not going to happen on the blockchain. So how does that happen? Well, maybe everyone's gonna use Coinbase. Maybe everyone's gonna use Chivo from the El Salvador government, right? Maybe it's centralized custodial solutions are the solutions to this problem. Or, because the problem with them is that they compromise on the security property of good money. And what the Bitcoin developers figured out that, hey, we can have this Lightning Network that does not compromise on the security property of good money. And so we can continue our journey of the future cyber currency longer until the Lightning Network gets full. Anyway, so my point is that without the Lightning Network, the future seems to be for a Bitcoin wallet that it has no business if it does not have Lightning Network. However, we cannot have a Lightning Network wallet without taking care of all the privacy leaks, right? Like how we are doing in Wasabi. So, and that requires a decent amount of research. And that's why we created a one Bitcoin grant for Lightning Network researchers. You can go to blog.wasabiwallet.io and you can find a grant there. I really hope some people would apply, some researchers would apply to this grant, because we did not actually receive any application yet, but yeah.
All right, well, anyone listening, you heard it here, okay? Go apply. I'm sick of this, you know, don't ignore it, right? It's a Bitcoin grant. But first off, beyond the Bitcoin that you can be a part of getting, you know, there's it's quite important to make sure that this sort of Lightning adoption, it takes place in a good manner, I guess, in a privacy conscious manner, at least I think, rather than everyone just using Chivo, you know, around the world or whatever. So yeah, and if you're out there listening and you got some spare time on your hands and you'd love to learn about Lightning, or you just know already about Lightning and you're already capable, go apply. Okay. You heard it. It was, I think it was blog.wasabiwallet.io. I think is what you said. Yes. So blog.wasabiwallet.io. Okay. Head over there. Okay. Yeah. That's interesting. I think that, I knew I'd heard it or read it or something, but I just couldn't remember when it was. I obviously that makes sense that it was at the conference. No, I'll okay, we'll leave it at that. But yeah, anyone out there listening, say check it out, blog.wasabiwallet.io. Is there anything else you guys wanted to say before we sign off? Anything else that people can do to help out, or you know, anything else? I mean, obviously you can check out Wasabi Wallet on Twitter. What else would you guys want to say?
You know what? Let me just zoom out to the big picture. We want to build a better money and basically fix the whole system what we have right now, and for that we need to make Bitcoin cheaper, faster, and more anonymous without compromising scarcity, security, and what other properties of good money. And I hope that's a meaningful enough goal for people. So keep up the good work, guys.
I did think of one last question. How soon is 2.0 going to be released? Is it like right around the corner, or are you guys still working on it?
I guess we're we have a internal like agreement for a concrete date for like what we've been referring to as like a preview release, so something that should really only be used on testnet still. And after that, we're hoping to nail down like a concrete like release candidate. That's something that's a little bit like the reckless launch of Lightning. So like, if you're interested and you feel that you know what you're doing and you're accepting the risk, that should be something that will do the right thing on mainnet, but like no guarantees yet. And after that's solid, then it should be generally like releasable. So for the internal like agreement about like dates, I think we've been aiming for like the end of December for this testnet release that people should be encouraged to actually use, and not just us or like hardcore users. More than that, I have difficulty. I think the criteria for success or failure are quite subtle, and the strategy in general was like we picked a very, very ambitious goal, and there were a lot of surprises along the way. So I don't want to say anything that I will later regret, but I'm hoping it's not much farther now. Adam, do you want to?
All right, I just want to say that we don't do deadlines, we do estimations. It's because we trust in our developers that they are doing their best work. I mean, how can I not trust them when I find them at 1 a.m. in the office still writing code? So they are really doing their best. And I did not have any good experience in the past when people tried to people told me that this is the deadline and this is when you have to be ready for, because I can be ready by then, but it's gonna be not as good. On the other hand, I would estimate myself doing this thing, be able to do it within 2 weeks, a complete release, but it will be as it wouldn't be as good, and the guys are really into the details of some of the stuff, so it will be fine. Also, maybe one nitpicking what you just said is that we had surprises. I don't think we had negative surprises, actually. Didn't we always just widen the scope? Oh, this is possible too, so let's build it that way. This is possible too. I don't think any of our initial plans were like, oh, that cannot be done. It's rather the opposite.
I guess that means I've been doing a good job of hiding all of my anxiety and dead ends and suppressing that unnecessary detail. For me, it was quite a wild ride of many places, like believing that it's impossible, or like thinking of this like auto coin join, no UTXO support, making it economical, making sure that edge cases and corner cases are taken care of. A year ago, I was almost convinced that we would need, it wasn't about what we could be doing, but rather things that I thought were necessary to make this even work. So for me, the last year has been mainly a process of convincing myself that we can leave some stuff out of scope for the 2.0 release and still have something that's minimally viable and more than minimally viable, like something that actually provides value and meets the design goals. There have been like unpleasant surprises, and there have been pleasant ones as well, more pleasant ones than unpleasant ones, but
we won't have coin joins into coin swaps with the Lightning network, right?
Definitely not for the 2.0 release. Yeah.
Not coming in a couple of weeks then. Okay. That's not a surprise. It's fair enough. Right, cheers, guys. It's been wonderful. It's been a pleasure to have both of you back for a second time, but together this time. It's been a cool, different dynamic to our usual as well, which is great. And I've enjoyed speaking to both of you and hearing about Wasabi 2.0. I'll be excited to see what it looks like. So once the official release, etc., occurs, then I'll be making a new wallet and checking it out. See how it differs, because I checked out Wasabi like twice before. I think I even used it once or twice, but anyway, it was great to chat to both of you, and it was awesome to have both of you, Jerry and Ricardo, here with us as well, as per usual. And to everyone listening, thank you very much. Take care, check out Wasabi on Twitter, check out the blog, check out Bitrefill while you're at it, and stay happy. Have an amazing evening, morning, afternoon, day, week, month, year. Take care, and keep buying Bitcoin.